This week we're looking at using equations in SolidWorks. I've got a part pulled up here. This is just a simple heat sink. I've created this part, and I want to show you how we can make it so that we can make many versions of this part just by using one dimension, by changing one dimension. And the dimension that I want to use to drive everything is actually going to be the width of the part. To add an equation, it's a pretty simple process. If you click on the bottom, it pulls up the different dimensions that are available there. And you can see my graphics card is having a little bit of an issue today, but you can see it's 120 by 70 currently. And what I want to do is I actually want to change this 70 dimension to be an equation. So I double click on the dimension itself, I hit equals, and that lets it know, just like in Excel, that we want to write an equation. Once I hit equals, I can actually select any other dimensions that I want to use. So in this case, I want it to be proportion of the 120 dimension. And in fact, I'm going to say I want it to be divided by 2 and then add 10. All right, so that should give me a value of 70. All right, I have to hit enter twice because it checks to see is the equation valid. And then if I hit enter one more time, it'll pop up. And you can see there's a summation symbol in front of my dimension now. That lets me know that there's an equation there. All right, so now if I change my 120, maybe I make it 150, we're going to see as I rebuild the part that the base of the part grows to be deeper and longer. Okay, there's a couple other things that I'm going to want to address here. For instance, I'm going to need more fins, and I also might want my fins to grow in height. So let me undo what I just did. All right. And now I'm going to go ahead, and the first thing I want to do is address the height of these guys. So you can see it's 40 here. Let's go ahead, and instead of making it 40, let's make it equal to, and again, if I select the bottom, it pulls up the dimensions, and I'm going to say I want it equal to 120 divided by 3. And actually, it's not 120, but it's equal to dimension 2 in sketch 1 divided by 3. All right, enter twice. And now, if I change that 120 dimension again, oops, let me get where I can see that. And maybe I make it 150. Okay, I'm going to roll it over and rebuild. And what we should see is the parts get taller and wider. All right, so you can see my equations are really driving the geometry of this part. All right, a couple more things. We can see as it grows, we're going to need to add more fins. Okay, so again, let's Control Z to back up. And now I want to look at this fin, the number of fins that are here. So to look at the fins, I'm going to select actually the first patterned feature. And notice this 20 that's hanging out here. That's telling me that's the number of instances in the linear pattern. If I double click that guy, it opens up and I can turn it into an equation as well. And I'm going to say that it's going to be equal to, again, I want to drive everything off of this 120 dimension. So it's equal to 120 divided by 6. Okay? Now, let's see what happens when I change that 120 value to be 150. Okay, roll it over, rebuild the part. Look at that. It filled it with fins. Okay, and in this case, they look fairly centered. The problem, though, is let's try a different number than 150. Let's try something like 140. We'll rebuild. Everything updates, but notice my fins are no longer centered. On here I have a pretty good size gap, and down here I don't have that big of a gap. All right, and this is because the placement of my original fin, this guy here, is just set with a static dimension. Well, I need to get those centered. So the way I do that, let me get to where my flyout menu won't be in the wrong spot. I select the dimension. Okay, there's my 150 that placed it, and I'm going to turn that into an equation. Now this equation is going to get kind of messy. All right, so I want the first thing I want to do is figure out how can I center that. And essentially, I want to take the overall length of the plate, subtract the length of the fins, and then divide that by 2, and that will give me the spacing on the end. Okay, so the overall length of the plate is if I select here, grab this dimension, and I'm going to put some parentheses in here. Just like Excel, you need to have kind of an order of operations. So parentheses, the overall length subtracted by, and now I need the number of fins, so I can again grab that linear spacing, grab this number here, okay, so that tells me the number of fins, And I'm going to multiply the number of fins times 6, because that is their spacing. Okay, and then I will subtract that from that 3. And I'm going to divide the entire quantity by 2. Okay, so I didn't quite get this done here. Just a sec. You can see there SolidWorks doesn't like it that my equation came up with a negative number. You can't have a negative value for a dimension. And what I had to come back and look at here was these parentheses. I didn't have my parentheses done quite correctly, so I've entered one here. And if I hit enter, it'll update. Okay, and I'll rebuild and look at that. Now my gap on this end is equal to my gap on that end. All right, so now we have this entire heat sink being driven based on the width you select. So if we change this from 140 to be 100 and hit enter, it shrinks it down to be a smaller guy, right? Again, I could look and say, let's go 200. It'll make a larger one. Rebuild it. And you can see if I wanted to spend some more time on this, I could set up as an equation the spacing for my tabs here, but I'm pretty satisfied with what I have. But this hasn't helped me at all with configurations. So now let's look at how we can actually set up configurations using a design table. Okay, so inserting the design table is actually pretty straightforward. Before we do that, let's go ahead and rebuild back to our original size that we were after. And I can do that by selecting the dimension again. Sorry, my graphics card is having a bit of an issue today. So we'll go with 120 and rebuild that. And we're back to our original part. Looks good. Okay, so now to insert a design table, I go up to Insert, Tables, Design Table. Okay, SolidWorks will help you do this. You can typically uncheck some of these boxes. And I'm going to say I don't want model edits to update this, and I'll hit check. So what a design table is it's actually using Excel to manage your values of some of your dimensions. Okay, so you need to select what dimensions you want included, and I'm going to go ahead and include all of these. Okay, so I just hit shift and OK. And what this does is it brings in all of the different dimensions into your design table. Okay, so it shows you the equations you have, and you can create different varieties by changing these. The thing you need to know about a design table is that the design table on the first column on the left is a different configuration. So if you want to add a configuration, for instance, maybe I want to change and have a new configuration that's 90 millimeters in depth. Okay, I can come in here and I can edit that and just say 90 millimeter. That's naming my configuration, and maybe I want 110 millimeter. All right, and then just like in Excel, I can select all the cells that I'm interested in, and if I use Control D, that fills down, it updates all those equations and pulls them down. All right. So now what I want to do is in my 90 millimeter version, I know that I would want my D2 sketch, and I'm going to want it to be 160. And in my 110 version, let's see, I think that's going to be 200. And that's the only change I'm going to make right now. So when we're done with this, if we go back to the part, it will update our table. And it didn't like it, so let's go back to Edit Table. And it tries to edit all within the same window. You also notice if I had clicked here and right-clicked, I can say Edit Table in a New Window, which you might want to do, and it pulls up Excel for you, which makes it a little bit easier. So it did not like me changing the name of this, so let's see if it will allow me to change that back. D2 at sketch 1. Okay, so I just updated my table, saved it, and closed it, and notice SolidWorks gives you a warning. The design table generated the following configurations, 90 millimeter and 110 millimeter. I'm going to go ahead and say OK. And now you can see I have 90 millimeter and 110 millimeter configurations of my part. Okay, this is a really powerful tool. We used it in a very basic format here, but the design table allows you to essentially set up geometry once and create all sorts of variations of a part. It's going to be really powerful for you to use. I hope this has been a good introduction. See you next time.